President Biden is expected to make an announcement as soon as today about a plan to forgive loans for millions of Americans. Sources say Biden could forgive up to $10,000 in student loans for people who make $125,000 a year or less. White House correspondent Mary Alice Parks joins me live now for more on this. Mary Alice, what more can you tell us about this plan? I know the White House has been a little tight-lipped, but what do we know at this point, and what impact is this expected to have?
Yeah, Diane, this is looking more and more likely, and we're also starting to hear rumors from sources that this announcement could include up to $20,000 in debt relief and debt cancellation for students who also received Pell Grants as a part of their financial aid package. Pell Grants typically go to sort of the most low-income students and families who are trying to earn that college degree. And I think this could have a really huge impact. Remember, over a third of borrowers have less than $10,000 in student loan debt, and they tend to be those who make less money year to year. Maybe they didn't finish their college degree, or they took jobs that don't have the same sort of wage potential. And so the White House thinks this is really helping people that need it the most, and really helping people who perhaps have been having the hardest time repaying some of that debt.
So what's the feedback? How are Democrats and Republicans responding to this?
Well, wildly differently, as you can imagine. I mean, Republicans are really blasting this. They say that it looks like a handout. It looks like a cash giveaway. Whereas you see some Democrats saying they don't know if this goes far enough. They were really hoping for something more that would perhaps help even more students and more borrowers. I mean, this was something that a lot of Democrats campaigned on. And remember, it wasn't just progressive Democrats. I mean, we had Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer really at odds with the White House over the last year, saying that something should be done on this, really pushing President Biden to act on this. Democrats view this also largely as a racial equity issue. I mean, black college students often graduate with twice the amount of debt as white counterparts, as their white counterparts. And over time, again, because of wage discrepancies, can have a harder time repaying that debt. And more students have had to take on debt over the last few years as tuition prices have gone up and up and up.
Now, the head of the NAACP says that this plan actually leaves black people and especially women behind. Why is that?
Yeah, again, the NAACP was really hoping, I think, for a more sweeping announcement here. They were hoping for a bigger numbers. I think that's part of the anxiety and frustration you're seeing in that statement. And the NAACP knows that black women just carry such a big part of this burden. Like I said, not only do black graduates carry twice the amount of debt on average, but black women especially often have a hard time repaying that debt because of the wage discrepancy once they graduate. We know that black women just don't make the same sort of dollar for dollar figures in so many workplaces compared to white counterparts, and that makes a big difference. We also just know that so often black families don't have the same level of wealth going into the college process. And so often that leads to black families having to take on more debt to begin with. Again, that's why we've seen so many of these Democratic organizations talk about student debt cancellation as a racial equity issue.
All right, Mary Alice Parks, we appreciate it as always. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.